Hi, welcome back to CADable. This is Engineer Ibrahim Omer, and today I'll demonstrate you how to use Surface Flatten feature in Solidworks. And let's start this tutorial. I will use this chair as a reference. So first of all, I'll go to your surfaces and I will use that surface. So let's offset the surface. I will select this surface and also I will select these individual surfaces. Basically, I have used my channel name here so that I will use this as a sketching entity when I will be using the surface flatten command. Okay, so let's go to your first surface offset, and I will use 0 mm so that this surface offset would be converted into copy surface. As you can see here, select OK. Now I can hide my solid body. Now you can see that your newly created offset surface. So let's go to here, surface flatten, and first of all I will select this surface and all these individual surfaces. Okay. Next is this dialog box, and it is asking you to select a vertex or point or edge on a flattening surface so that your flattening surface would be starting from that point. So let's say I'll go to here and I will select this edge. And now you can see the preview of your flattening surface, and here is the mesh size. Now I can increase or decrease this mesh size, and let's go to here, this dialog box, additional entities, and here is we can add additional curves, or we can add, let's say, some sketch, so that this sketch is basically projected onto this newly created surface. So I will select this sketch one by one. So after selecting all these entities, I will select this box. And now you can see that your newly created surface is flattened. I will hide this existing surface. And now you can also see that this sketch is basically projected onto this flattened surface. And just right click this. I can check this deformation plot. So you can see that the red ones are the stretching zones and the blue ones are the compression zones. And you can see that this deformation is maximum here and this deformation is minimum here and here. Okay. Now I will transport this file into AutoCAD DWG or DXF for machining. So just right click and I'll go to here, export to DXF or DWG. I will select this one. And now I can change this to, let's say, DXF or DWG. So I will select this one, DWG, and I will select, let's say, chair layout blank, and I will set the directory as desktop, and I will save this. Select OK, and now you can see that the preview of your chair layout in AutoCAD, and I will save this one. So that's it for today's tutorial. I hope you like it, and if you have any questions, any queries related to this tutorial or any other tutorial in my list, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more informative and interesting projects. Thank you.